Okay, let's read it. The boy was so far away he couldn't hear his mother when she called to him. Ah, now after you read it, do you see the homophone? Haiti, which one do you think makes the most sense? Which letter? A, B, C, or D?
A.
A, do you agree with her? Give me a thumbs up if you agree with her and a thumbs down if you don't agree with her.
La redada migratoria más grande en la historia del país.
Evidence of identity theft and fake social security numbers.
May 12th, 2008. I was in sixth grade. There was this helicopter coming and going, coming and going, coming and going.
Illegal immigration puts pressure on public schools and hospitals
state and, local
and brings crime to our communities.
It is against the law to hire someone who is in this country illegally.
My heart is really breaking.
This was an absolutely massive action.
Escapando de la casa con los hijos, lo mismo que los judíos se sintieron cuando estaban en Nazi Germany.
What did the raids accomplish? Nothing.
Who's going to cut up your pigs? Who's going to milk your cows? Who's going to work in your packing plants? We actually have a much more diverse population than we ever had before.
Estas redadas hacen estragos y ahora peor que nunca.
When we first arrived, my mom worked at the plant. And she was in charge of cleaning the chicken. When I found out that I was undocumented, I was very self-conscious because I felt like that made me less of a person.
It was a little scary at first, I think. You're kind of dating an illegal, but I don't look at it that way. I don't see Ludwin the DACA recipient. I see Ludwin my boyfriend.
Home?
When Trump won, my brother was pretty excited. Ludwin was pretty disappointed.
Oh, I could probably work at the mall.
You could be really stereotypical and work construction in the corner. Like,
so there you go, I'll do a stand in front of Home Depot.
People still bring up the raid, but it never really affected me.
Oh, boy. It's crazy the amount of fear that that day just instilled in us.
And nobody else laughed, like, except for me.
It kind of made Postville famous in a not so great way. As a kid, you grow up and you don't realize that anything's any different than anywhere else.
Postville is actually a pretty small town, even by Iowa standards. It was actually a trading post area. The initial settlement of immigrants there were predominantly Germans.
Well, we've always been an agricultural town. We've had a meatpacking plant that has gone through several owners, and the big change was when Jewish people from New York bought it and turned it into a kosher meatpacking plant.
And the idea here was to come out to the source and produce the kosher meat here and ship it out.
A lot of people were afraid that the Jewish people would take over the town.
You
didn't have a lot of people around to even apply for those jobs. About 1993, we started to see tremendous growth in the Latino population in the state.
We were aware that some of them were illegal, but nobody wanted to do anything about it. It was bound to happen.
La verdad es que yo fui a Postville porque me comentaban de que ahí había mucho trabajo, lo que es en empresa de agriprocesor. Yo llevaba 20 minutos de estar adentro de una empresa cuando llegó migración.
Dos helicópteros Black Hawks, 1,100 operarios federales, cientos de ellos con chalecos blindados y ametralladoras, una operación paramilitar.
Muchos que se escondieron, los golpearon. Mujeres lloraban. Y muchos de los hombres también. Entró con una 9 milímetros en la mano y dijo que el que se meneaba iba a disparar. Nos tuvieron como 6 horas tirados, sentados en casi cada metro, un oficial de migración.
ICE agents executed criminal and civil search warrants at the company, resulting in the arrest of 389 undocumented alien workers.
We need to hold employers to account for the workers they hire.
We're still figuring out which people that we have in custody may be charged, so we don't know if we have fugitives.
Me llamaron desde Iowa para un trabajo.
Nos llevaron a Warilu y ya tenían preparado, como decirte, como tipo corral de vacas. A la par había un salón.
Muy simpático, estilo años 50, donde hacen square dancing. En esta ocasión, lo habían convertido en un tribunal federal. En el medio de la pista de baile, el escudo del Departamento de Justicia. Tienen unas 400 personas aquí.
Íbamos al baño, encadenados de los pies, encadenados de las manos.
Se veía que era gente muy humilde, de Guatemala en su mayoría.
Los mismos abogados, ellos te estaban diciendo, firma tu deportación.
Había un abogado por cada 20 acusados. Eran abogados criminalistas que no sabían nada de derecho migratorio. Estaba todo preparado de manera que fuese como un tren de justicia. Se declararon culpables bajo coacción. Tenían que aceptar 6 meses de prisión y luego deportación automática sin recurso ninguno.
Me llevaron a una prisión federal ahí a la par de Chicago. De Chicago fui a Luisiana.
St. Bridget's at that time acted as a sanctuary. The food, the utilities, the rent. Basically, we were taking care of the most immediate needs of the Hispanic community.
Moms, dads, kids, almost every square inch of the church was covered by a human being. I've been in refugee camps around the world and seen human suffering, but the trauma that I saw in that room was absolutely tremendous.
My parents were scared. They had no idea what to do because, you know, what can you do? That was the last time I saw a lot of my friends, because if their parents didn't get arrested, then they just got up and left and moved somewhere else.
La división de esta familia fue la redada. Las decisiones que tomó el gobierno. A través de la deportación de Posvil, mi primo organizó un grupo para guías de turistas al volcán. Es una responsabilidad muy grande. Yo me siento muy contento con ese trabajo y agradecido con Dios que nos ha dado este tesoro muy grande que está aquí, que es muy turístico. Con un día de trabajo logro ganar lo que gano en una semana trabajando en el campo. Yo ya le debo $2,000 a lo que es el coyote que nos llevó. Cuando yo fui arrestado, tenía la bebé que nació en Estados Unidos. Heidi es la única que es ciudadana americana. Esa era mi preocupación, decir qué iba a pasar con ella. El alimento de las otras niñas y mi esposa que estaba allá.
Yo sentía que volverme loca ese día. ¿Dónde está Jorge? ¿Que dónde lo fueron a dejar? Como yo no supe ni oí nada de él, yo me desesperé. Fue como yo me vine para Guatemala y me traje a las niñas. Traje a Heidi de 7 meses.
¿A cómo lo menos?
A 5 años, pues.
La verdad es de que nunca se pensó que se iba a ir de temprana edad para Estados Unidos. Fue muy duro. Porque no lo puedo olvidar porque cuando se despidió de todos, muy contento. Pero para mí fue duro porque dije yo, ¿cuándo lo voy a ver? Hasta hoy día que no lo hemos visto.
Esta tiene mamá.
Me siento rara por no tener a mi familia cerca de mí, pero mi maestra dice que soy muy valiente.
¿Cuántos de los que estamos aquí ya somos cristianos? Le servimos al Señor.
Yo traje a Heidi porque yo conozco a los papás
y les dije que si me la daban para que le hiciera compañía a mi niña. Para Heidi fue un cambio bien muy rápido porque ella no sabía leer ni poner su nombre y aquí pues, sabe hablar inglés.
Quiero tener muchos más porque no me dan como abrazos o así.
¿Alguien más está cumpliendo años en esta tarde? ¿O ya cumplió la semana pasada?
Todos aquí tienen papás. Yo soy como la única que no tiene papás.
Ya tengo 10 años de estar aquí, en Posby. Llegué de Guatemala, empecé a trabajar a la semana en Agristar. Desde ese día, pues, sigo trabajando ahí. Nunca me trataron mal, ni los encargados, nadie. Por ellos comemos y ellos por nosotros sacan el producto.
No es un lugar muy limpio para trabajar, un frigorífico, hay sangre, hay grasa. El trabajo no es el más lindo que hay, pero es un trabajo que la gente tiene para ganar el pan. Hay muchos, muchos trabajos aquí en los Estados Unidos que no creo que lo van a poder hacer sin traer inmigrantes de otros lugares.
Part of our workforce that work in this facility, it is a large percentage of immigrants.
Quite a while to get the plant back open. That transition there was extremely painful. The Jewish community suffered very badly because their plant got shut down, so they weren't working.
Mi trabajo lo perdí inmediatamente. No tenía dinero. Estaba seco, seco. De 1,000 trabajadores en la planta, quedaron 100. La comunidad judía se fue de como 120 familias a 40, 30. Eso afectó a toda la county. La gente que vendía autos, vendía ropa, vendía zapatos, gente que la conozco del trabajo o de ser vecinos, la tragó la tierra, desaparecieron del mapa. No fue fácil para nadie.
chops.
What?
Chop chops. Let's go.
Don't stop.
I'm hungry.
Believing.
I'm getting hangry.
Hey, yo, somebody got a shovel there.
Yeah.
How are you?
Bridget.
I don't know.
Give me some Cajun.
When my mom stopped working at the plant, she met a couple Jewish ladies and they became friends and they just offered me, hey, like if you clean my house, I'll pay you this.
Okay.
That Jewish lady told her friend and then she told her friend and so on. So then my mom had like her own little business, cleans houses.
Leave my limes alone.
Heavy
weights.
95.
Yeah. I spent all these years just wanting to be legal. And then DACA was introduced, and I was able to get my papers.
There you go.
Come on, up.
Good.
My goal still is one day become a citizen. I am currently going to school. I want to be a teacher someday. I work at a restaurant.
What can I get for you?
And at the local YMCA.
One, two, three. All right.
I do a lot.
Look at the space. All right, that's what I want you to do.
That Mexican whatever cheese. The...
Okay, first of all, what do you mean by Mexican cheese?
Okay, so like there's a specific thing that has like Kobe Jack.
Anything else I can do for you?
No, thanks.
Thank you.
Have a good day. Thank you. You too.
Bridget and I went to school together.
Do you want thighs or tenders?
She was definitely the person that helps me be a better version of myself.
Thank you. Just that. Oh, you're so kind.
There was a lot of rumors after the raid that immigration was just gonna go door to door and try to get as many people as possible. It was definitely a ghost town. After that, Somalis started coming. They're just like us. They're here for work and they are nice people.
My family is actually very big, but only my dad and my brother right now live in Iowa. I was born in Somalia. My dad, they remind me every day, be thankful that you have a meal in your desk. I admire my dad so much because he works really hard, almost 60 hours a week. He sends a lot of money back home in order for people to survive.
Se va a llevar. A 4 lléveselo. ¿A 5? Sí, a 4 le doy. Deseara hacer una paloma e irme volando y la ver. Yo deseara irme de mojada, pero no puedo. Allá tiene lo más necesario que yo nunca le pude dar acá.
Yeah, so that really should come out.
And I got 12 occlusal periods.
Yeah. So, Haiti, have you been to a dentist anywhere?
No.
So we're going to try and find a dentist for you, okay? Because there are some teeth that have cavities, okay? And we'll send a letter home to your family, too. Okay?
I'll have you sign it.
Oh, shoot!
Vender frutas y mi hermana trabaja y una vez se ayuda a mi mamá.
¿Se está carota la hoja?
Sí.
A mí me gustaría que ellos estuvieran en la escuela para que aprendieran más.
Les he dicho que el futuro un día que yo ya no esté, Heidi se los va a dar. Que Heidi va a ser como un varón para ellas. Quieran mucho a su hermana. Valoricen a su hermana. Porque un día su hermana va a tener lo poco que es necesario y se los va a dar de todo corazón.
After the Postville raid, we did see only one other major workplace raid, and ever since then, there have been relatively few of them. Now we're starting to see, again, some of the larger workplace actions. Many of them are starting to look just like the ones we experienced in Postville.
Donald J. Trump, from this day forward, it's going to be only America first.
Es un regreso a las políticas de la administración Bush.
It has happened again.
ICE agents carrying out one of the largest workplace immigration busts under the Trump administration.
Raided stores all over the country.
Arrested in Northeast Ohio.
Charged with identity theft and tax evasion.
Targeting dangerous criminal illegals.
God, that took everyone.
We have to listen to the concerns that working people have over immigration and its impact on their jobs, wages, schools, tax bills, and general living conditions.
The base of the current White House has made it very clear they want stronger enforcement. The lessons of Postville, unfortunately, are now lost.
Who's paying?
Rock, paper, scissors.
Rock, paper, scissors. Okay, all right, that's right. All right. 2 out of 3?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. There. Oh, let's try again.
Yep. You're broke.
I know.
Hey, was that Drew?
Do you get tacos?
Yeah. You got, oh, why don't you get tacos from over there?
Because I'm white.
Bro, you get tacos over there.
But I'm white. I like American tacos.
But they're better.
All right.
That's a matter of opinion. My opinion differs.
Have a good day. See ya.
Overall, I think that my family is conservative. Politics isn't the place for you to have emotions.
The majority of Trump supporters are against immigrants. When it comes to Drew, I really don't think he's against immigrants.
Ludwin is a great guy, but at the same time, you know, you are here legally, and I know that that was no choice of his own, but it's still wrong.
I really don't understand how you can live in this town and be against immigrants.
We need to make sure people are here only if they're supposed to be here. When the Somalians were coming in, everybody was weird about that. I'm not saying that all these people are bad. There's a lot of good ones, but as a whole, I feel their community is negatively affecting our town. They just kind of keep to themselves, and they're not integrating well. I don't think there's any perfect way to filter out who's supposed to be here and who's not. I'm a high school student from a small town. I'm not a politician. That's not my call to make.
Como yo fui testigo de la redada que hubo aquí, no quiero ver que hagan eso a otras personas. Eso no tiene que pasar otra vez más.
Si volviera a Guatemala, quisiera trabajar con mi papá en el volcán. Me costaría mandarles dinero y que se compren como cosas bonitas.
A veces yo me hago esa ilusión si estuviera allá, como estuvieran mis hijas estudiando, y al lado de mi hija que está en Estados Unidos. No hubiera habido necesidad de pasar pobreza aquí en Guatemala.
The older generation might not be hanging out with each other. Our generation will be way different than our parents'.
I was scared to death when I got here. I didn't know how to interact with different cultures. Everybody that spoke a different language, I just kind of looked at it. And now I call it cultural whiplash. because I see people that come to Postville to watch our activities from outside communities. And when the Somali girls come walking in with their hijabs, their heads turn so fast and they stare, I'm afraid they're hurting their neck. That doesn't faze our kids. We are much more diverse than we ever have been. We have well over 50% minority students, somewhere around 14 countries represented. This is different. Well, yeah, it's different, but it's the same.
Told you.
I think over the last 10 years, we have learned acceptance. The raid did happen.
I didn't believe you.
It's something that people are going to know us by. But the raid doesn't define who Postville is.
Hoy celebramos la diversidad no solo de la comunidad del distrito de Postville, sino también esos de América. Este país está basado en las...
There's a fear in the community. We see kids not come to school at times because we find out that there was maybe ice in town last night and they're scared to come out of the house.
La quinceañera elige un acompañante para el día de su celebración.
For years, I would go back to that town and say, this town has not recovered. I think about the Postville raid almost every day of my life. You know, one of the takeaways I still have is that you can plan and you can hope to achieve things through actions like this. But the immigration business and the presence of immigrant and refugee newcomers is so dynamic that all the long-term planning in the world can mean absolutely nothing. You now actually have a more diverse workforce now in this state than you used to. Did it work? No, because people kept coming. I just want you to do everything my mom had done. And then tell me if we shouldn't be here, or tell her that she shouldn't be here. And that's something people don't understand. It is very difficult to come here legally.
If people had honest moments, they realized that these folks weren't here, the rural economy would fall apart.
This completes our program for this year. Thank you very much for coming, and enjoy your weekend!
Hold on. Let me fix myself.
Okay.
Thanks. It's actually the one that Bridget gave me to wear at the Halloween party at Brick City.
Oh. I think the raid definitely helped just kind of bring us together. Postville is a prime example of what immigrants are.
Dude, my camera died halfway through.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
It has one thing that it's shown over and over, resiliency. It's the little town that could. I think that's remarkable.